So all you need today for this painting that we're going to do is your primary colors of red, yellow, and blue, and some green and brown and some white, and you can put some black on there too if you want. These have really nice bristles and they're great for your trees and your bushes, and this is going to be used for your background, okay? And then we have a flat synthetic brush, chiseled edge, and I have a flat a filbert brush, which is chiseled edge and synthetic, and I also have a liner brush. Now I'm going to experiment with the color. I am going to, for the background for this beautiful ballerina painting, I am going to make a gray-green color, because green is the complementary color of red, which is her dress. All right, so I'm just going to put on some gray. I'm going to mist it with my magic mist. These are the great bottles for mist. I tried these other ones, like for my magic mist when I made them. I tried this bottle and it sticks, you know. Look, it won't come out. And I tried, you know, bottles that I already had around the house, and they just stuck after a while. And then I tried these here and they didn't work very well either. So I had my son shopping with me that day, and he said, try these. These look pretty good, and I did, and they're perfect. So I got them at the dollar store. They work great for the magic mist. Now, any of the other bottles that I showed you work great for just water, but with the magic mist, because there's mediums and that in there, it's probably going to thicken up too much or something. But it wouldn't work anyway, and you know, for me, maybe other people, nobody complained yet. So if I hear anything, I'll certainly let everybody know what's the best bottle to use. So I'm just going to throw on some of my grayish color. But see, look, I misted it with the magic mist, and that will keep my paint wet a lot, nice while, so that I can blend all these colors so they won't dry on me, and then I won't need to use a big pile of paint. I just need to use a smaller amount of paint. So I'm going to add more white over here, and then if it starts to dry and you just mist it again, that's all. The beauty of the magic mist is it won't thin out your paint too much. It won't make it too transparent, you know, because if you use just water, your paint will probably turn into like a glaze. It'll be too transparent, but with the, and it will help you blend better. All right, so I just want to get this on here now. I'm going to mist it a little bit more. Probably should have used my magic mist, magic paint, I should say, magic white. I got magic paint, magic white, magic mist, magic clear. Everything's magic. Magic brush. Yep, I'm making my own, well, it's not my own line of, you know, magic stuff, but everything that I use is amazing, and it's like magic to me, so I just call everything magic. So, a little bit of blue in there, that's fine, that's fine. I want to start adding a few colors now because I don't want it to be totally gray. I just want to start off with gray to get it started. All right, so I'm starting to add a few little colors. I want to get it more on a green side, because if I'm going to use a red dress or orange, then blue would be good for the orange, a blue background. So either a blue background or a green background. All right, so I don't know if we should make our dress more of an orangey color. I don't know. It doesn't matter. We'll add a little bit of green there too. What the heck? Let's just have some fun with the colors. Look, but because I got the magic mist on there, so that'll blend beautifully. Look at that. It's not drying on you, see? So you can add red, green. The green is pretty. Look at that. Isn't that pretty? I like that. That's really nice. Oh, yeah. A little bit of green over here, too. And see, I can do this because the canvas is still wet, see? And it's wet, and the magic mist is letting it blend beautifully without destroying what's underneath. Wow, it's beautiful. You got to try it. I think you'd be very happy. A lot of people said it was a game changer. All this magic mist and magic white that I made. Okay, so keep going. And maybe we'll add a little bit of blue just in case her dress turns a bit orangey. All right, so a little bit of blue, a little bit of green. We've got the gray. Oh my, we got some beautiful colors going on there. And look, because the magic mist is not blending too much, it's all staying separated. Isn't that nice? That's why I call it magic. It's just like magic. You know, I'm not exaggerating. You'll see when you start using it. And it's, you know, it's not something that that I'm selling. Not right now. I would like to, but I need to find a manufacturer. And then I could sell it then, because a lot of people do want it already bottled. But you can make your own. I have the recipe there for you. All right. There we go. That's kind of nice, isn't it? Maybe there's some light going on somewhere. Maybe. I don't know. Just add some light here just for now. And always change it up when we decide where light is coming behind her. I'm just going to lay a little bit there for now. All right. Nice, isn't it? Yay. Now let that dry and then we'll put the pattern on there. So this is a stretch canvas and it's a size 12 by 12 and you can paint the sides if you want. So you can see it's stretched over some wood. Yeah, it's pre-stretched and it's pre-primed and all that good stuff. That's why I love to buy my canvases either at the dollar stores or Walmarts or wherever you can get them. And they're fairly cheap. It's good for me because I go through so many. I'd never be able to afford it if they were $10 each, you know, so you can get them for $10. You should be able to get them for around $2 each, $2.50, $3, depending where you shop, and depending on the size also. See, like this one here is a nice big one. This one is 16 by 20. Love 16 by 20s. I mean, if you shop, I bought that at the dollar store. I call it dollar store. There's so many different ones. The Great Canadian Dollar Store, the Dollarama, you know, any store that's those types of stores. And as you see the price, right, like $3.50. I mean, you know, stretched, pre-primed, ready to go, you know, no hassle. I love these canvases. Never, ever gave me any trouble. Never, ever. You see them on my walls. You see these paintings on my walls. And some of these have been there for years and years. They never faded. They never fell apart. Nothing. Work fantastic. All right. Other supports that I use are the flat. You know, I practiced on the back of that one there. Sometimes I do that. You know, there's a painting I did recently of coffee time, and that's just a flat canvas board, right? And sometimes I use both sides because I go through a lot and a lot. I'm trying to save some money, even though I get, you know, support from my patrons, and I get it's really hard to keep up with everything that you need. And this one here, this is the one that I was talking about earlier. This is paper. Right, stiff. It's mixed media paper, so you know I painted on that, and they're great too because you get like 30 sheets or 60 sheets for $12. You know, you get 60 sheets, I think 9 by 12 during my Amazon shop for 12 something US, and I mean, you know, a lot cheaper than the canvases, but I love the canvases, I won't give them up, you know, so it all helps. But that's what I paint on. So anyway, here we have the reference photo. I use it, I found it on Pixabay. I love Pixabay. There are lots of other places, but I love Pixabay because it's easy to find what I'm looking for. I just have to do one search and I go into the illustrations. That's where I found this one, in illustrations. If you go under photos or images, you get the real life ones, and I find illustrations are more colorful and easier for painting. So this is the, then I transferred my drawing. I have my drawing on my paper. So draw it out either freehand or trace it somehow. And then once you get it on your paper and you're happy with it, then you put it on your dry canvas, okay? And transfer it. Don't try to draw it on your canvas, because if you make mistakes, you're going to have a hard time cleaning it up. So draw it on your paper first. Transfer it to your canvas using carbon paper, all right? Carbon paper is okay. You have the lines there, but they're easy to cover up. I find them easy to cover up. Don't, the black lines do not come through. Not for me. Now, some people have a hard time. Maybe it's because their lines are too black and too thick. Sometimes you use charcoal. It's really messy. So let's get started painting. I have to decide now where I want to start painting, okay? I have a small flat brush, chiseled edge. Make sure you get chiseled edge, because then you can get to the lines and get up close to the hands. I'm just trying to think, should I do her body first? I think maybe that might be a wise choice, because then we can start the skirt after. Now get some of your burnt sienna. We're going to start with white for the flesh tone, depending on how dark or light the skin is. I'm just going to make our skin light because it's against the background, it's kind of dark. If you're going to have dark skin, then make sure your background is nice and light so it'll show up. Okay, so light skin, a darker background, all right? So that will help you make a decision. Start over. Okay, so we go white, and we're going to add for flesh tone some burnt sienna, depending on the color of the flesh you want, the skin. If you want it dark, make sure you use burnt umber or more burnt sienna. And you have to have a light background if your skin is going to be dark. If your skin is going to be light, then your background could be a little dark. And there's a little bit of red, a little bit of yellow, a little bit of green. All right. A little bit more red. You have to make adjustments. Be careful with the red. It's very powerful. Lay it to the side. Like, go like that first and then bring it in, okay? And that way you don't have too much. But that's not a bad little one there. It's not a bad flesh tone there. Look at that. I think it's okay. We'll find out. So then you just start putting that on. You may need two coats. It's a bit light. I might tone it down a bit. I think I will tone it down a bit. I'll just add a little more. I'm going to add a little burnt umber. That will tone it down even more. There we go. That's better. That's better. A little bit of white. There we go. So the burnt umber brought it nice. So, put it on here. Use your chiseled edge to keep up against those lines. You better, if you sat down to do this, I'm standing, so it's a little bit of a struggle for me. But, so, keep our flesh tone going. Try to keep the shape of that arm. Just keep that chiseled edge up against that line. That way you'll get rid of the line, plus you will have the shape. Okay. Good. need a small brush. Finding that brush too big, so I'm going to try a smaller filbert, and if that don't work, I will try a round brush. I just want to tell you what I'm doing. Sometimes I have to change brushes. I might tell you what brushes to use, and if I did this painting, if this is the second time doing a painting, sometimes I'll do a painting twice. That way I will know what brushes to tell you to use. But even so, even if I did this before, I still may change my mind and use a different brush. So I keep that line there so I know where her face is. All right, so I'm just gonna leave her lips out. I know where her eye goes, but I'm gonna just sort of keep those lines if I can, just for a guide. Her ear there, and that's her ear back there. And don't worry too much if it's not looking, it looks funny at first, as long as you get the shapes. If you get those shapes, then you're on your way. That's the big thing, is getting those shapes. If her face comes out like a pineapple, then you know you got the shape wrong. I wanted to mention, now, see? You can see the shape better, okay? Now if you want to put some shadows on while we're working on that, take some burnt umber, mix it in what you already mixed, right? So it's gonna be a shadow color. Right, see it's darkening up there now. And we're going to put that shadow under here. If it's not dark enough, add more. Have a little bit of shadow on the edges here, and on the bottom here. You can rub that in a little bit, just to blend in a little with your finger, would you believe? All right, so we'll be adding more highlights and things to that. So I want to see what her legs are like. I'm going, sort of going by the reference photo, but I'm just going to sort of make up my own too, because it doesn't have to be exactly like the reference photo. I'm trying to envision where the light is coming from. So if the light is coming from the top, throwing itself down over these arms, then it's also going to hit the backs of those legs. So, all right. So it's going to hit those legs. There's some shadow here. I'm just going to scrub that in. We can add some highlights after. And the other leg. Make lots of shadow up under here. There we go. Still keep that flesh tone that we had there. I'm not really trying to get rid of it. I'm just trying to get everything to blend. I'm just going to add a little bit of white to my brush so I can kind of blend this together a little bit. Then I can get rid of that line at the edge here. So just have your shadow on the right side, and on the left side was the light flesh tone. And then now we're going to just bring them together. Get rid of that line that we made with the carbon paper. So just paint over that. Try our best to keep all this. All right, so just move it together. And if you end up, just say you go over here too much and you lose it, we just put it back in again. That's okay. All right, right now we're just trying to get some idea of where the shadows go and how they look. We know where they go, we just gotta see how they look now, right? blending that together there. Not looking too bad, right? Not looking too bad. Add a bit of, just a bit of light coming. Like I said, there's light up here, and that's blue. We don't want blue. My flesh tones. Make sure your brush is clean. Sometimes you get mixed in with other colors. If that starts happening, which it can, then make sure that you clean your brush. Alright. And then we'll get some of that highlight on here. That's where the light is shining on her arm. So look for three values, right? Dark, medium, and light. And this, make sure you find out where your light is. That'll make it so much easier for you then. And this way you can go over that line that was there too. See how that little bit of white just brings it right out? It's a light on the back of her leg here. The light is shining off the back of her leg. I mean, what a difference it makes. See that? Isn't that cool? It's just pure white that I have in my brush. My brush is a little bit dirty, which is good because that won't be a chalky white. It'll be nice and bright. There we go. Good. I'll soften this up a little bit more. Yeah, I like that light on skin. All right, now her top is black, so let's put some black on her top, get that started. A little strap up here, use the corner of your brush that we got to get in there. You have to use the corner of your brush, or you pick up a small round brush, whatever works. All right, good. And her hair is black, so I'm gonna get a small round brush for that. So her hair is black, so paint her hair black. Thank you. I'm just going to paint all this and I'll put the bow in after. You can have whatever kind of hair you want. You can have long hair, you can have... Usually ballerinas have their hair flowing or tied up. She also has, I'm going to use burnt umber for her eyebrows and her eyelashes. So burnt umber on your flat brush, or your, sorry, your little round brush. Umber. Let's see now. Hopefully this brush is small enough. There we go. And her eye. I'm gonna close her eye because it's much easier. Oh boy. And I'm going to give her red lips. We have to do her face again with some flesh tone because, as you can see, it's not complete. All right. So get a nice pointy top to your round brush so that you can use the little tiny top, see? Help you get in by your lips. Nice. Don't have to be anything too fancy. Alright, we'll do her skin tone again. I'm just gonna keep this brush. I'm just going to go into what I already have here. The white. I want to get her skin tone a little brighter because this, her face was brighter, wasn't it? Red, yellow, white. Turn around at the brush so I get a nice little tip to it. Let's see if I can get her face better than what I have. Gotta be careful, her hair is still wet, it could go into the face. I might wait for that to dry now, and then I'll come back to that after. See the mess I got myself into? See? So I'll come back to that. We have to come back to that stuff anyway. Put in more shadows and highlights. Alright, got that much started. So let's try maybe do something with her skirt that she has on, because that's a really pretty skirt. See if we can capture some of those flowing, beautiful, looks like maybe satin, not sure. What can we use? Let's see, a nice flat brush. I would think a small flat brush might help. So let's take some of our, let's see, maybe some white, just to get it started. And yeah, because I tell you why, if I put red on there now, the background's gonna come through. So this white will help give it a basis to come in, right? We'll give a basis for it when you put the reds on, okay? So let's just try and capture some of these little flowy pieces. I'm not going to make it exactly like the reference photo because it's a lot going on there, and I just want to make it easy for you if I can, you know, and for myself, you know. Make it for easy for me too. Let's just put that on there and see what happens. Just get some of those, I don't know, just like that. So you can go as far as you want with her skirt. You can play around with that whatever way you want. Okay. There's another tutorial that I noticed on here, similar to this one, but they're different, you know, like there's art tutorials, and because we're all artists, we all come up with, you know, we're all doing landscapes, seascapes, ballerinas, cars, trucks, you know, you've probably seen, and you'll see, like if I go look for the paint the rose, I don't want to see just one tutorial, I want to see several different techniques. So this is a good thing. So if you find another tutorial with a ballerina similar to this one even, then you'll get that person's technique and you'll get this technique, and then you can pick the one you like the best, or you can just put two of them together and come up with your own, or you know, take some of the techniques from one video and you know, play around with it and see what you like best, and it makes it a little easier for you because now you got several ways of different ways of doing things. So I'm going to give her white, would you believe? White shoes. I think that would be nice with the red dress. But while I got my white out, I might as well put that on there, hey. Okay. There we go. Just paint it in right here. Good. And we're going to put a shadow in, just add a little bit of a gray color. for the shadow. Just on the edge there, so keep the light. I may have to fix it up a little bit. I can see that I kind of made a boo-boo there. So I will fix that up. So I'll make sure you know. I don't want you to follow me and then you end up doing a really weird looking shoe. Have her foot all deformed there. All right, so we'll fix that. All right. Looks nice though, doesn't it? All right, let's start with some red now. Go back to our flat brush. Let's try that dress. Make sure the white is dry because the paint will turn too pink. And her dress has some dark shadows in it. So we'll start with the red and we'll add a bit of burnt sienna or even burnt umber to tone down that red. Bring it down to a nice dark red. See? See how nice and dark that is? But yeah, it's still red. It's a very dark red. So going by the picture, just use the chiseled edge to bring in these. My paint's a little bit still a bit wet, okay. And just kind of follow that. Looks like the flow goes up this way, okay? So red. Going up this way. And over. I want to keep some of that dark too, right? I'm going to mist it a little bit with my magic mist, but not too much. Oh, it's a lot. That's okay. So I'll get that to move now. There we go. It's better. It's magic. And you don't have to use that. You can use water if you like. Mist it with a little bit of water and get your paint to move, okay? Okay, go over her leg. That's fine. Go over her leg. Take advantage of that water that I missed, put on there, that magic. Make it kind of like a, like you can see through it more here in some places. So magic mist will make it more transparent if you don't use too much paint. So kind of make some crisscross strokes, short strokes. Give it kind of a flow feeling to it. More shadows in here. Goes up and around. Yeah, that's nice. Yeah, it's almost really dark, isn't it, here? You look at the reference photo. You can look at the reference photo now too while you're painting to help you. But I don't want you to get caught up in being too much like the reference photo because you'll struggle too much and you won't get it done. Just put your strokes on and just see what happens. You know what I mean? Like, just kind of let it flow and see what comes out of it. Right? Put some more red up here. I don't want it to be too transparent. I want it nice and red. I'm making these nice on the chiseled edge of my brush. Making these curvy lines. All right, curvy lines. You don't want the lines to be straight. You don't want it to look like it's just red. You want to give it some feel to it, like it's moving. So it's going to make it transparent, but I don't like that. So you can change your mind. It's okay. You can add a bit of white to your brush and kind of bring in some of that highlight up here. Chiseled edge. That's nice, isn't it? See how that brings it out more? That's pretty, I like that. Maybe it's a little bit up here. A little bit of white up there, just because we said the light is coming down through here, right? So. Nice. Yeah, that white really adds flavor, doesn't it? Adds interest and flavor. Mix them out here. Kind of like you can see through it. Go. That's pretty. I like that. Now let's try the other one. What did I do? I can't remember. Let's see. Get your dark red. And we got the skirt is flowing down this way into that side, and it's flowing down this way into that side. Okay. And again, we will make these curvy lines. Right, so your red and some of your burnt umber. If you don't have burnt umber, just brown with a bit of black, okay? It's really a dark brown is all it is. You know? Just kind of flipping that up around this way. It seems to flip down and up, doesn't it? To make that stand out, we'll take some white and red, kind of give it something like that too, right? So that'll be your highlights, but that's okay, keep doing that. You can see, you want to be able to see those lines, right? In order to make it look like that dress is really flowing. Just pushing some more of these. So pretty. Just floating around there. Wow. Go out and around like that, and that way you can pull in. And then we can get, what we're doing is we're putting on our dark red, and then we are adding our red. See the red there? And then we are adding a little bit of white. That'll bring it out even more. See? So you got your three values again, dark, medium, and light. Nice. It's kind of light down here, so we'll go with the red. Nice bright red. Now we want to get pointy tip on that. You can put your chiseled edge down and then sit down and come back, okay? That way you'll get that nice little top up there that you're looking for. A little bit of shadow going on there, which is fine. My paint's getting all dirty. It's fine. All right, and then get some coming out here and here. See, I'm more concerned with the shape of the skirt. I want to make sure I get that correct, and then I'll worry about my, you know, correcting my highlights and my shadows after. I just gotta get something on there to see what I like, you know, if I like it, if I like what I'm doing. All right. So far it's nice, I like it. There we go. Now. Nice shadows going on there and in between, look at that. Where did all that come from? Where did all that come from? I didn't mean to have that much. I'm gonna clean my brush. And I'm going to clean it off a bit, and I'm going to start putting in some red. That's too much there. Okay, good. Now once you add a little bit of white to that, it's going to really pop. Okay. I'm going to pop. See how it pops? Isn't that pretty though? We need some highlight on top of here because that light is really jumping off of that. See, all this is happening because your paint is still wet, okay? If your paint dries on you, just keep going in with your red, dark red, and your light, okay? And that way it'll all stay wet. It'll stay wet with you. Pretty. And as you can see in the reference photo, there's some stars going on there, and I don't know, what should I do? Should I put some white around here or something? I wonder. These are decisions that you have to make. You have to make these decisions to see if, you know, how it's going to work out. Now, you're not going to be touching her. You're going to be doing this canvas. So if you fool up, if you don't like this, you can always go back to the color that you put on it, okay? I'm just going to go by what I see on my reference photo, and I'm just going to scrub on a bit of white here just to see if I like it. Kind of nice. Kind of gives a nice edge to it, though. Oops. Nice. Here we go. Not bad. Yeah, that's kind of nice. Try the other side. It's got it all around there. Most of the light is over here. I'm just trying to see. Scrub it on. And as it's drying, I'm going to dry brush the rest of it. Kind of dry brushing it. Now you don't have to do this if you don't want to. Kind of gives it a little bit of a, I don't know, not bad. Scrub on some down here. Bad. It gives it a bit of light, you know, gives it a bit of light. Now what I want to do is use my magic brush. I know you're on magic brush? What are you talking about? Well, I'm talking about my magic brush that I use for my flowers, but I'm going to use this for some stars. Okay, see how they're all opened up individually? They will point the stars for you. But see, in this, there's some stars, right? See? So let's add some of those with this little brush. Just tap right into your white. Like that. And we pick some spots where we want to add some stars. Just boink, 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 boink. Why am I saying boink? Okay. So this way you'll be able to do a bunch of these without having to do them individually. All right. This is your booster shot. Just going by the picture. It's all around here. This brush is a big help when you want these little things going on. these little stars going on here. Isn't that nice though? Right? That's cute, isn't it? Just dip into pure white gently, just so you can get the tops, right? You don't want big blobs, but you want enough to be able to get it to come off. And gentle, gentle. Be gentle, right? And you put them wherever you want. You don't have to go by what you see in the picture, not unless you want to. You know, if you're going to go by this reference photo, you're going to be struggling. But if you just do whatever you want, and it comes out whatever way you want it to come out, and you're happy with it, long as they're not blobs, you should be okay. Right? So you can put them all around. Right? So then you're not worried about being exactly like the reference photo. You don't want to be like the reference photo. You want to do your own thing. Look how pretty that is. Look. Isn't that cool? So we're not going to worry about anything. We're just going to enjoy putting these on here. You don't have to overdo it either, okay? So leave that center part. All right. That's nice, isn't it? And if you want to bring out some little stars and you want to make them look like they're stars and you got some, just make a little star, little boink, boink, like that. So while they're still wet, just grab one and pull out some of these lines to give it a star look. Just pull out. They can be short, they could be tall, they could be long. Some are long and some are short. Right? Still has to be wet. If it's not wet, then just put some more water, put some more paint on there. So pick out a couple wherever you want them and just pull out the glow. Little glow coming out of the stars or whatever they are. There we go. We'll just grab a few while they're still wet. Grab a few, pull them out. There we go. See? Just pull them out like that. And you got some cute little stars going down there. That's nice. Now we'll finish up her face and any little highlights that we need, and then we'll call it finished. And you certainly can do whatever you want to it. You can certainly add more highlights and all different kinds of things, whatever you want to do. So just get another brush, a small round brush should work, and we will play around with her face and her hair. So what we want to do is, I want to add a bit of highlight to her shoes. I'm just going to add a little bit on the edge here and on the heel. All right, I'm going to add a little bit on this side over here. Foot comes down around this way, and we will add a little bit of highlight to her hair, just a little bit, not much, a little bit, and we will add a little bit of highlight to her shirt, just a little bit here, just to bring it down, just to show the shape of the shirt. Just a little bit of highlight, that's all. And then just to bring it out a bit, and then we will add flesh tone. All right, some white, that's some red, too much red, start over, white, and your bit of red, a little bit of burnt sienna, a little bit of yellow, a little bit of green in there too, and more white. Trying to match it up a little bit with what we already have there, right? Just using my round brush, I'm going to bring some highlight here to finish that. Kind of went dull on me. All right, wherever you think you need extra, get her flesh tone on there. Add a little bit more brown if it's too... Well, come down on our chest here, lighten that up a small bit. A little bit back around her neck. That's where all the light is, see? See that? So you can leave some of that shadow under her chin there. And then we have her nose. Her cheek and her ear, keep her eye. This might be a little bit tricky. Take your time. Not like me, I'm kind of trying to get this done so that I can get the video done for you. So there's lots you can do. So this here seems to have to come down here a bit more. Now that was a bit darker there, I think. On that edge, yep, there it is. I added a bit more brown. There we go, that's better, because her foot was kind of off a little bit, wasn't it? So let's finish off her hair and her face. And I have a small round brush. And I'm going to use my burnt sienna or burnt umber, whatever you have there, to make a little bit of an ear here. And a shadow behind her ear. A bit of a shadow under her chin. Just trying to blend it in there. Shadows, you know, kind of make it, helps bring it together. Right? And get her eye in there. That's nice. Nothing wrong with that. A little bit of white here where this light is. Okay. It's okay. Not to worry. Good. An easy fix. I like it. I like it. I hope you like it. A little bit of shadow under her nose. Like I said, these little shadows will bring everything out, see? Right, it's a little bit of shadow there, you can see. See her eyes? See, nice big long eyelash, don't she? Right? I think it's cute though, isn't it? It's nice. You know? And when you stand further away from your painting, it looks even better. So ballerinas have to have straps. Well, they're not straps, but a little bit of a cream color I'm going to use. A little bit of white and a tiny bit of that flesh tone. But it's too close to the flesh tone, you won't see it. But, you know, some straps going on here. Got a whole lot of shoes on. Right. So you got a little one here. And a little one come across here. And some more going up here. Good. And then the other one. It's one going across here. I'm going across here, crisscrossing here now. And one on top. Okay. So yeah, you have to have something there to hold her shoe on. I'm thinking this might be a little bit higher. Make any adjustments that you need to make, you know, don't make adjustments, but don't try to be exactly like, use the reference photo to help you, of course, get the shapes correct. You know, because her toe is going straight across there. So I'm going to put a little bit of a shadow there, I think, to a little heel up here. Just use the reference photo to help you put things in place. That's better. I think that's better. And that's about it, really. So I'll just put a little highlight on the back here so you can so the light is shining on that. See? And here. She has the back heel there. That's a bit of light there, so that's good. There we go, see? That's better. Okay, so I think we'll put a little bit of a shadow under her feet just to ground her. So the shadow can be gray. White, because and with a bit of green added to it, because the background is kind of green blue, so we can just add the green, blue, gray. I'm just mixing a bit of black, make it a gray, green. Okay, just see, so you go with the colors, so gray first, and then add green to it, and away you go. And the shadows are going to So the light is here, so shadows are gonna come out here a little bit. Kind of grounds her, you know. Right? Grounds her. She's grounded. That looks better. That's better. Nice. So that's it for now. So I'm signing out from Allison Prior. Happy painting, everybody. Bye. Well, thank you very much for painting along with me, and I hope you enjoyed that painting. And if you liked this video, then you can subscribe so you can get more free videos. And you can like, share if you could, if you think it could help other people. And if you have any questions, just leave it in the comments section below. And you can email me at allisonprior@yahoo.com. So I'll see you in the next video.